Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Dear all, in previous session we have discussed problems in exercise 2 of pair of inequations in two variables. Now in this session we will discuss the solutions of question number 9 and 10 from the same exercise. Okay, in that question number 9 is, in this exercise, question number 9 is, a chemist has two solutions of hydrochloric acid in stock. So there is two solutions of hydrochloric acid HCl in the stock, and in that one is 50% solution and the other is 80% solution. One having 50% acid and the other one has having 80% acid. Now the question is, how much of each should be used to obtain 100 milliliters of a 68% solution. So to get 100 ml of 68% solution, how much of each should be added or used to obtain 100 ml is the question. That means to make 100 ml of 68% solution, how much ml of 50% solution and how much percent of how much ml of 80% solution should add, we have to find. Okay, for that let us consider we have to mix XML. In that mixture we have to mix XML of first solution and YML of second solution we have to add in that mixture. Okay, for this let us consider first solution contains 50% acid and the second solution contains 80% acid. Okay, so I am adding that one. Let first solution contains 50% acid. Okay, and the second solution contains 80% acid. Okay, 80% and 50%. Now we have to mix these two solutions to get a mixture, new mixture. Further, let us consider XML of first solution and YML of second solution. You must add in that mixture. Let XML of first solution, and YML of second solution we must add. YML of second solution are added. Okay, then from this what can I write? Total how much ml? 100 ml of liquid we want. How much? 100 ml of liquid. So that for this then we can write that x plus y is equal to 100 ml. Okay, according to quantity. Now according to mixing of the acid percentage, according to percentage, so we can write 50% of x plus, yes, first solution contains 50% acid, then 50% of x plus second solution contains 80% acid. So that 80% of where we have considered second second solution as YML, okay, is equal to 68% of 100 ml. Okay, 68% of 100 ml. We have to write like this equation. I repeat, 50% of first solution plus 80% of second solution is equal to 68% of total solution, that is 100 ml. Clear? Now convert into like this, 50 by 100 into x plus 80 by 100 into y is equal to 68 by 100 into 100. Is it percent means per 100? Okay, it's cancelled. So total multiply by 100, then it becomes 50x plus 80y is equal to 6800. And then what is the common table? We can divide this one by, so multiply by 100. Okay, multiply by 100. Since multiply by 100, we got like this. Now 50x plus 80y is equal to 6800. So in this tenth table is common table, is it? So divide by 10. Divide by 10, then we get here. Divide by 10, we get here. 5x plus 8y is equal to 680. Consider as second equation. X plus y is equal to 100 is first equation, and 5x plus 8y is equal to 690 second equation. Now we have to solve these two equations. So which method is applicable here? We can use any one of the two methods, either elimination method or substitution method. So better consider elimination method. So what is the first equation? Coefficients of the variables 1, 1. Here 5h. So I want to eliminate the value, the x term. So that I am multiplying the equation 1 by 5 and equation 2 by 1. Okay, since the LCM of the coefficients of x and in the first equation and x coefficient of x in the second equation is 5. Okay, here 1 5 LCM and the 5 kavati equation 1 5 tonu. Already ikkada x coefficient of 5 undi kavati equation 2 ni 1 tone multiply chesthe manaku saripothundi. Okay na? So multiply equation 1 by 5 and equation 2 by 1 itself. Then it becomes, first equation becomes 5x plus 5y is equal to 500. Okay. And the second equation multiply by 1, so that no change in the equation. So 5x plus 8y is equal to 680. No change in that. Now subtract, we can cancel. Why we have to subtract? Because here 5x, 5x are like terms but having same sign. So that if you subtract, these two terms will get cancelled. 5x minus 5x is 0. 5y minus 8y minus 3y is equal to minus 180. Okay, clear beta. Now minus minus gets cancelled. 180 by 3, that is equal to 60. So here y is equal to 60. What is the meaning of y? Yeah. Second solution is ymn. Okay. Now put y is equal to 60 in equation 1. To get the value of x, it is comfortable for us, because if you substitute the value of y in this equation, it is easy to find. Okay, so x plus 60 is equal to 100, then x is equal to 100 minus 60, so x is equal to 40. X is equal to 40. Now what is x? It is the quantity of first solution. How much ml we are using to make a 68% solution? Yes, 40 ml of first solution and 60 ml of second solution are adding in that mixture, is it? Okay, therefore quantity of first solution is equal to how much? 40 ml x. Next, quantity of second ml is how much? Therefore quantity of second solution is how much? 60 ml. Total how much? 60 plus 40, 100 ml. Is it clear? So this is the solution of question number 9. It is select model, and we discuss now question number 10. Okay. Now see the solution of 10th problem, the last problem of this exercise. You have 12,000 rupees saved amount. So you have 12,000 rupees amount with you and wants to invest it in two schemes. Such that you should get 10% interest and 15% interest. Okay, you have 12,000 rupees amount, and you have to invest in two types of schemes. That is, you have to get earning 10% interest and 15% interest. These are the two types of schemes. And how much amount should be invested in each scheme so that you should get overall 12% interest on that amount? Okay. For this simple thing, they are given total amount 12,000 rupees, and you should get 10% interest and 15% interest, which are having these type of interests by investing in two types of schemes. Type 1 is getting 10% interest, and type 2 scheme is 15% interest, getting 15% interest. Okay. Now you have to invest this amount in each scheme such that you should get overall 12% interest. Okay, for this let us consider let the amount be invested at 10% be x rupees, and let the amount invested at 15% be y rupees. Okay, let the amount to be invested at 10% be x rupees. Okay, and the amount to be invested at 15%, okay, 10% and 15%, amount to be invested at 15% be y rupees. At 15% be y rupees. Okay, let the amount to be invested at 10% be x rupees and the amount to be invested at 15% be y rupees. I can't do problem. Sum of these two is how much? 12,000 rupees. Okay. According to problem, total amount is given 12,000 rupees. So that x rupees plus y rupees is equal to 12,000 rupees. So that we can write here, we can get an equation here. That is, x plus y is equal to 12,000. Considered as equation 1. Okay. So like this, we get one equation. According to problem. Then the other one is, here 10% of this x rupees plus 15% of y rupees is equal to overall percentage is how much here? 12% interest. So that 12% of 12,000 rupees. So we can write here, and also we can write here 10% of x rupees plus 15% of y rupees is equal to 12% of 12,000 rupees. 12% of 12,000 rupees. So that we can write here 10% means 10 by 100 into x plus 15 by 100 into y. Is equal to 12 by 100 into 12,000. Okay, clear? If you observe both sides, here 100 gets cancelled, then what is the remaining? 10x plus 15y plus is equal to 12 into 12 is 144, 3 zeros. So 144,000, is it? If you observe here, the common table is 5 table. We can divide by 5 table. So divide by 5 table. Divided by 5, then we get here 5 2 is 10x, 5 3 is, and 5 2 is 10, and the remaining 4 44, 5 8 is 40, again 40 remaining, 5 8 is 40, 2 zeros. So 2x plus 3y is equal to 28,800. Now if you observe first equation and second equation, here x plus y is equal to 12,000, here 2x plus 3y is equal to 28,800. Okay. Now by elimination method we can solve these two equations. So we can eliminate any one of these two variables, okay, either x or y. So I want to eliminate the variable x, so that I am observing the coefficients of x in both the equations. In this equation the coefficient of x is 1, in second equation coefficient of x is 2. So the LCM of 1 comma 2 is 2. So multiply equation 1 by 2 and equation 2 by no change, so that multiply by 1, clear? Okay, so then it becomes 2x plus 2y is equal to 24,000, and the second equation is as it is because we are multiplying by 1, so no change. So 2x plus 3y is equal to 28,800. Now as usual, if we add, we are unable to eliminate any variable, so that I am subtracting. Then 2x minus 2x is equal to 0. Then minus y is equal to 28,800 means 4,800. So y is equal to how much? Therefore we can write here y is equal to 4,800. Y is equal to how much? 4,800. Now put y value in any one of the equation, we will get x value. But for us, the first equation is convenient to get the value of x, so that I am substituting the y value in first equation, that is x plus y is equal to 12,000. So x plus 4,800 is equal to 12,000. Then x is equal to 12,000 minus 4,800. Then the difference is 0, 0, and then 10 minus 8, 2. Here 11 minus 4, 7. So x is equal to 7,200. So the value of x is equal to 7,200. What is x? The amount to be invested at 10% rate of interest. So here the amount to be invested, the amount to be invested at 10% rate of interest, that is equal to how much? 7200 rupees. And then what is the meaning of y? The amount to be invested at 15% rate of interest. Therefore, the conclusion dialogue is the amount to be invested. The amount to be invested at the rate of 15% rate of interest is equal to 4800 rupees. Okay, clear. This is the solution of question number 10. Is it easier? Very simple. The given problem you have to read well, and what is given, what is required, you have to identify, and the required you have to denote in terms of x and y. Then you will get one equation, and by the relation which is required, from that you will get the second equation. We have to solve those two equations either in elimination method or substitution method as per our convenience. Okay, clear? So, okay guys, we will meet in the next session with another concept. So, this is about the solutions of question number 9 and 10. I hope you are clear about these solutions. And in the next video, we will discuss another concept of another chapter. Till then, bye-bye.